It's Tuesday, January 9th. We are saying good morning football to you, Kay and Nate and Peter over here with Kyle, because we are about to go to journalism school. But keep it here on NFL Network all day long, because you can see John Gruden's live introductory press conference right here on NFL Network at 3 p.m. Eastern. Triggs, I feel like if I close my eyes and listen to it, it would be a fun game to be like, is that Sean McVay talking?
Yeah.
Or is it John Gruden talking? I wouldn't know.
No, you would not know.
No. Sounds like a segment. I like that. That's a good idea.
What
Let's
if we
tomorrow.
Did it? A soundbite? Yes! Time for the lead block.
Lead block.
We'll do that tomorrow. For right now, let's go to journalism school. I'm going to ask you guys the five burning questions that you learn in J School 101. The who, the what, the when, the where, and the why. So let's start with the who. The number two seeds both have home games this weekend in the throwdown round. Who do you trust more at home? The Steelers inviting the Jags, a little rematch action, or those Vikings who nobody's been talking about, and we're hearing a lot about it on Twitter.
I'll go with the Steelers, because I think about what would be more surprising talking about Monday morning, that the Saints went in to beat the Vikings, or that the Jaguars with Bortles et al. Went into Heinz Field and beat the Steelers. So I trust the Steelers more. I also think they're the most talented team in the entire NFL, so I'll go Pittsburgh.
Now, I understand it was different teams who came into those buildings.
Yeah.
This is a rematch in the same exact situation in both places. So I saw the Jaguars in the regular season go in and give the Steelers that business. I also saw the Saints come up to Minnesota and get beaten on Monday night. So I'm going to say the Vikings in the dome with that home crowd, which they had a home playoff game against the Seahawks a few years ago that I went to, but it was outdoors at that college stadium. It wasn't the Metrodome. This place, I've been in this place enough times to tell you, it is going to be impossible for Drew Brees to hear a thing. The Saints' young players have never played in a situation like this, in a building like this.
Yeah.
I'm going with the Vikings at home as a better advantage than the Steelers, just because I know that Jaguars' defense is going
to
show up.
That was at the University of Minnesota. Shout out to the Golden Gophers for the hospitality. I'm going with the Vikings as well, because at home they've embraced something defensively that is the best in the NFL, and that's teams are averaging just 12.5 points. So if you can hold teams to 12.5 points in the postseason, where most of these teams are flying around scoring 20 or 30 points, I'm going with the Vikings on this.
I trust them both equally. Both 7-1 at home this season. All right, next up, it is the what. The Saints got a huge victory over the division rival Panthers on Sunday, their third of the year. They swept them, and their head coach brought a prop to the postgame celebration. If you haven't seen this enough, take a look. What do you guys make of Sean Payton's locker room broom celebration?
The locker room?
The locker room.
What do you think, Shrugs?
At what point in the game or walking to the locker room did he at first think of the broom?
Immediately. He thought about it right before the game. He's like,
you think so, or do you think this was just pretty spontaneous? The guy had
somebody gave it to him.
Look at that little broom. It's
really
like a fireplace.
Spontaneous. I'll say this. I love it. What do I think of it? I think this is great. It depends on your team. Now, if this was the New England Patriots, I would say, nah, this isn't their style. But because their team is so young, so brash, and even if you look at, I saw a clip yesterday of Mark Ingram celebrating, and there was a guy who came into the screen.
He's lurking in the back.
And he's grooving, and it was Drew Brees. And he was doing his thing, and I was like, that is their team. That basically just defines what they feel about each week and how they go out about the business. So I love the fact that he brought that broom out.
We keep showing it, right?
It's not for everybody. Look, and we're a young show. We're all about the celebrations. It's not for everybody. And if we're going to preach sportsmanship and playing things the right way, that isn't the thing you show up to young kids. That said, this is what the Saints are, right? Like, do you think the Panthers, you know, Cam Newton does this. Like, everyone does their own thing. Cam Newton does this in player spaces.
A head coach. That's unusual.
I know.
Does this bother you more or less than the dirt cutter Peyton exchange?
I don't think any of it bothers me. To me, it's like WWF. It's all entertainment. Yeah. It's all for the viewers. And for us on our show, it's great content. Sean Payton is one of the true characters of the sport. He's unlike any other coach in that he puts on the black hat and this renegade persona
that's true.
I am the villain and I'm going to do this. And look, he's got to face Ron Rivera not only next year two times, but the year after that, the year after that, the year after that. This truly is a man who does not care about the repercussions. He will see Ron Rivera at the owners' meetings. He will see Ron Rivera at the combine. He doesn't give a crap. And for that, characters welcome. Bring it. I like it.
The fact is, Sean Payton went through a career-altering experience. He was suspended for Bounty Gate, and I'm sure he has a lot of resentment for that. And I think he challenges that kind of thing, or channels it, rather. I'm not going to show this to my son and say, this is how you do it, but you go ahead. You beat the Vikings this weekend, put on the Viking helmet, run up and blow that horn. This is who the Saints are. You don't change who you are in the playoffs. Do it.
Are we too sensitive, though? Because if this was the
90s... Who's me? We all like it.
I'm talking about in general, as a society. Because in the 90s, if this happened in the NBA or NFL, we're like, we love this.
Yes.
If Jerry Glanville
people had a broom, line. It'd be awesome.
But now everybody's like, oh my God, it's so disrespectful.
Listen, I've actually seen one person say it's disrespectful.
Talk trash. Yeah.
Have you guys seen that on Twitter or something?
I haven't looked.
I haven't seen any of this. I don't know who these people are that we're talking about.
I feel like there's a segment.
Traditionalists are basically saying, well, you know, it's a little bit too much. I mean, he's a head coach. No, like, he's celebrating.
Okay, it was one thing after the other, too,
the people that would be against it aren't on Twitter.
Right.
You know, it's the people at home.
They're on Facebook, for sure. My Aunt Patty is way against this. She's got some thoughts.
Facebook is the most hostile place.
It's the worst place in the world.
All right, let's go on to the when. Stop looking at Facebook. Pay attention to school.
Okay,
we're in class
Aunt
right
Patty.
Now. The Bills were eliminated in the wild card by the Jaguars, and as we know, it was Buffalo's first postseason appearance since way back in 1999. And congrats to them for making it in. I want to know when. Mm. When will we see them back in the thing?
So what, 18 years? So 2036? So we're in season 20 of Good Morning Football. Peter's still riding the Lions. I don't know, okay? It's a really hard question because I don't know their quarterback situation. I genuinely don't. If they start anew next year, I think if I had to give you my most honest answer,
yes,
I would say 3 years from now, because they'll have a new quarterback who they've developed and Tom Brady will be out of the league. That's what I would say.
That's a good point. I was thinking the same thing. I can't answer this question until I know who's going to be their quarterback.
Yeah, I don't know.
But their defense is so strong, I will say less than 5 years. It won't take them a decade or even 20 years.
I
would agree with Kyle. I'll say 3 years or less.
Okay.
They'll be back that quick.
Go on, Peter.
How about next year?
Do what you were born to do, Peter.
Next year. They were a good team this year. They made the playoffs this year. They're young.
Quarterback, Peter.
It doesn't matter.
Peter, they made the playoffs on a miracle that would never have happened, and now they don't have a quarterback. You know what I mean?
What's the quarterback situation with the Dolphins? A lot of questions around the whole division.
I don't think the Dolphins are going to make the playoffs.
No, but this is a good point.
So if they don't, and then the Jets don't, we don't know those quarterback situations.
Nate, who is the quarterback this year that made it?
Listen, I'm just saying, we don't know if Tyrod's going to be there, and if Tyrod's not there, Nathan Peterman is going to be your guy, and he's throwing
Nathan Peterman
is throwing six interceptions.
They've got two first-round picks in a quarterback-rich draft. They've got veteran free agents all over the place. They held the Jaguars to 10 points. The offense was completely inept. If you get another touchdown, you win that
game.
The
assumption is those puzzle pieces are going to work, though. I'm not going to blindly make a prediction that they'll make the playoffs next year when I have no idea what their puzzle is.
The puzzle pieces that matter are the ones in the division. To Kay's point, the Jets, what are they doing? The Dolphins, we don't know. They're also in flux. So aside from the Patriots, the division is up for grab for a wild card. It's not wildly unlikely.
Yeah.
And they have LeSean McCoy. All right, on to the where. Another head coaching job was filled just yesterday, which we will get to in a minute, but that leaves four openings now. The Colts, Lions, Giants, and Cardinals. Where, gentlemen, is the most desirable remaining coaching spot? If you were one of these coaching candidates, where would you most like to go?
I'm buying a ticket, a one-way ticket, and I'm going to the city of Indianapolis.
Okay.
And I am looking into the barrel of the gun, and I am saying, please, please, Andrew Luck's shoulder, please, 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 please heal up, because it is worth the roll of the dice to have that guy as your franchise quarterback. He's the golden goose. He is everything. And, oh, do we
risk
him in the NFL? I would do it. I would roll the dice, and if that doesn't work, Jacoby Brissett can win me some games, too.
This has come up before, and I usually go with the desert, because I love an outdoor shower. I love that desert living. But I'm going to go with my head here, and I'm buying a ticket to the city of Indianapolis. I'm going to live in Indiana, okay? The natural rivalry between Illinois and Indiana. They call us Phipps. It's not pleasant. But I think the stakes are lower. The golden goose is in the mix. The defense is young. The division, I think we can take it. I don't want any other ones. I want Indiana. The Colts, Tony Dungy.
You just want to be a four-hour drive away from Georgia so you can babysit the kids.
I do. My mother, I really would, Kay. It's a great point.
I know that.
David Letterman,
can
we
I
love
get
you.
A great choice.
I'm buying a ticket
where
to
you
Indianapolis.
No.
And then I'm getting a rental, and I'm driving to Arizona.
Drive, Nate.
Listen, we know that Carson Palmer is retiring, which means even though Drew Stanton finished the season strong, they're going to find themselves a young star quarterback. And not to mention this guy right here.
Yeah.
We're talking about Le'Veon and Mark Ingram, and Alvin Kamara, and Zeke Elliott, and Tucker. David Johnson.
Remember him?
Healthy. You remember this guy? The one guy that was an MVP candidate with the worst line in football. He is going to be your starting running back with a defense that is still stout. Oh, and not to mention, it's Arizona.
Hello.
Inexpensive living, sunshine. So when you have an older player that's banged up, the sun rays are going to heal you up like more than before. So I'm going with Arizona Cardinals.
As the only Good Morning Football member to never have been on a Lions dinghy, I'm ashamed at the three of you for not picking Detroit.
No one picked Detroit.
Matthew Stafford, you're not looking down a barrel at what Andrew Luck's going to look at. You know you have a good quarterback that might need a little bit of a change. And Darius Slay, good defense. NFC North sort of up for grabs and shaky right now. Come on.
Yeah.
You're going to go to Indy?
We
got to
play Rodgers twice a year. Trubisky's the next big thing, Kay.
Finally, the why. Speaking of the NFC North, the Bears picked their next head coach just yesterday, former Chiefs offensive coordinator Matt Nagy. Why? Why is the question to wrap up Journalism 101? Why is Matt Nagy the right hire for the Bears? Make the argument. Or don't.
Peter Schrager says he's great, that he's been saying it for months. And Mitchell Trubisky is the franchise. He is the company. He is the future. Trubisky can't bomb, or the Bears could blow half a decade or a decade waiting for him to be good. I want someone to coach him up. And the fact is, the last time somebody hired the Chiefs offensive coordinator, I worked that pretty well. He's coaching a home game this weekend. His name's Doug Peterson.
That's true.
Oh, I would also go with that. Who he's learned from, whether it be Andy Reid, and then you go down the whole chart of that, but Brad Childress is a good offensive mind. I think Matt Nagy interviewed his butt off with the Bears, and he kind of made it that they couldn't hire anyone else.
Yeah.
He's young, he's energetic. We saw Sean McVay with the Rams. Everyone's looking for that next wave. This is their guy.
His resume is strong. He is the right man for the job, but there is an element of potential and what he hasn't reached. So for a free agent wide receiver who's a third tier wide receiver, puts up 500 yards, mm-hmm. People think, oh, we want to sign him because he can put up 1,000 with us. Simple fact that he took over play call and they played so well. Now teams are saying,